oogenesis. Oogenesis is the gamete formation process in female. It takes place in ovary. The ovaries produce both gametes as well as sex hormones such as estrogen as well as progesterone. The process of ovum production is called as oogenesis. Only one of the meiotic product becomes a gamete. In contrast to spermatogenesis, it will form 4 mature sperm. In oogenesis, the other 3 cells, which is polar bodies, will simply deteriorate without becoming a functional egg. Before birth, millions of oogonia from primordial germ cells are present in the ovaries. All of them are formed during embryonic development. There is no oogonia formed after birth. Women have limited reproductive capability, where it begins at puberty and it ends in her 50s or before that. In the developing female fetus, the oogonia multiplies by mitosis, and then it begins meiosis process, and then it stops at prophase of meiosis 1. At this stage, the cell is called as primary oocyte. Primary oocyte is surrounded by single layer of follicle cells. At this stage, they enter a resting phase that lasts throughout childhood until puberty. Beginning at puberty, a hormone called FSH will be released and stimulate a few follicles to mature each month. As follicle matures, the primary oocyte completes its meiosis 1, and it will produce 2 haploid cells. However, these cells are differ in size. The smaller cell is called as the first polar body. The polar body will be divided into 2 more polar bodies that will later disintegrate. The secondary oocyte, on the other hand, will remain in metaphase 2 until it is fertilized. If you look at the ovary, you can find secondary oocyte at the growing follicle and the mature follicle. The follicle will grow bigger until it is time for ovulation. You can see secondary oocyte in mature follicle is surrounded by layers of follicle cells that is called as granulosa cells. During ovulation, secondary oocyte will be released into the oviduct through the ovary wall. The adjacent wall of ovary will be ruptured and secondary oocyte will be released. The portion of follicle that remains in ovary develops into corpus luteum. After released from the ovary, secondary oocyte will travel to fallopian tube or oviduct. This action will be aided by the cilia at the epithelial cell. At the oviduct, the secondary oocyte have greater chances to be fertilized. During fertilization, the secondary oocyte will complete its second meiotic division and give rise to a single ovum and second polar body. Fertilization usually takes place in the fallopian tube. If there is no fertilization, secondary oocyte will move into the uterus and it will later be disintegrated. Remember, if there is no fertilization, the secondary oocyte will not complete its meiotic stage. So this is all for oogenesis. Thank you.
Female reproductive system requires control from these hormones. They are GnRH, LH, FSH, estrogen, and progesterone. Hormone regulation of female reproduction involves the hypothalamus, pituitary gland, and ovaries. The beginning of menstrual bleeding marks the first day of menstrual cycle. A typical menstrual cycle lasts for 28 days, but it varies from woman to woman. Ovulation, on the other hand, usually occurs about 14 days after the first day of menstrual cycle. However, this is also varies depending on the woman's cycle. There are two closely linked reproductive cycles in human female. The first one is ovarian cycle, which divided into follicular and luteal phase. The second one is menstrual cycle, which divided into menstrual flow, proliferative and secretory phase. The ovarian cycle. The first phase of ovarian cycle is follicular phase. In follicular phase, hypothalamus release GnRH after puberty. GnRH will stimulate anterior pituitary to secrete FSH and LH in small amount. FSH stimulate follicle growth aided by LH. The cells of growing follicles starts to make estradiol. Therefore, you can see a slow rise in the amount of estradiol secreted. Estradiol secretion by the growing follicle begins to rise steeply. The secretion of FSH and LH level increase markedly. The increase in estradiol secretion from the growing follicle stimulates hypothalamus to release GnRH. This will lead to increase in LH concentration. This is the example of positive feedback. The maturing follicle contains an internal fluid-filled cavity. It grows very large, forming a bulge near the surface of ovary. The follicular phase ends at ovulation. This is in response to the peak of LH level. During ovulation, the follicle and adjacent wall of ovary rupture, releasing secondary oocyte to the fallopian tube. Luteal phase begins after ovulation. In luteal phase, LH stimulates the follicular tissue that left behind in the ovary to transform into corpus luteum. The corpus luteum secretes progesterone and estradiol under continuous stimulation by LH. The combination of high level of progesterone and estradiol exert negative feedback towards hypothalamus and pituitary. This will reduce secretion of LH and FSH. If there is no pregnancy occur, corpus luteum will disintegrate due to the low level of LH and FSH. This is near to the end of luteal phase. As the corpus luteum disintegrate, it will trigger the sharp decline to estradiol and progesterone concentration. The decreasing level of this hormone will liberate hypothalamus and pituitary from negative feedback. Therefore, pituitary can begin secreting FSH to stimulate the growth of new follicles and initiating the next ovarian cycle.
The menstrual cycle. Proliferative phase in a menstrual cycle is parallel to follicular phase of an ovarian cycle. In proliferative phase, the growing follicle secrete increasing amount of estradiol. This will signal the endometrium layer to thicken. Secretory phase starts after ovulation. Estradiol and progesterone secreted by corpus luteum stimulate the continuous development and maintenance of the uterine lining. This involves the enlargement of arteries and the growth of endometrial gland. The endometrial gland will secrete nutrients fluid to sustain early embryo. In menstrual flow phase, the rapid drop of estradiol and progesterone level is due to the disintegration of corpus luteum. This will lead to the disintegration of endometrium layer. The uterus will constrict in response to prostaglandin. The disintegration of endometrium involves small blood vessel in the endometrium constrict, and it will release blood that is shed along with endometrial tissue and fluid. The result is menstruation. Thank you.